In this video, we are going to take a look at using seeds in your DBT project. Seeds are essentially CSV files with data that you can then reference as if they're another table or model in your project. Some good use cases that they mention here are mappings of country codes, a list of test emails. Seeds are best suited to static data, which changes infrequently. And really what they're trying to drive home here is you don't want to use seeds as essentially a way of loading raw data that has been exported to CSVs. It's more for using as a reference point. In this video, I will show you how to create a seed file, how to deploy it, and then how to reference it in a model. And so as mentioned, seeds are really just CSV files. By default, DBT will look in your data directory for these CSV files that you're looking to load. So if we hop back into our project, we can see here by default, it puts this data pass here as data, meaning it is looking under this data folder. Right now there's nothing in it, so this is where we can put in our example CSV file. So in this example as background, the model that I'm going to use to start is one called team. It just has a list of a couple NBA teams, and we are going to create a seed file that has their associated city and state, and then we'll join them together to create a different model. Here's an example of the CSV file that I'm going to use. Back in here, we can create a new file and call this team locations. Let's call it that. .csv, because this is a CSV file. And all I'm going to do is copy and paste this in here to hold that CSV file. I could have just dragged that file in here, but decided to copy and paste it. Now the first step here in using seeds is to actually deploy this. And the way to do that is through the dbt seed command, which is going to load anything in that data pass location to our project. And right now we have this here. So let's go ahead and do that. dbt seed, one seed file. It recognizes this here. So it should grab that and load it. Okay, so it inserted public team locations, inserted four records. Let's take a look. Public team locations, there it is. So we can see this loaded our data. And again, this is a decent example because this is information that is not likely to change. It's more of a reference. So now how can we use this in a script? Let's say, you know, how would you actually use this in a real model? As they mention in here, you can reference it like this. So you reference the name of your seed file. In this case, they created one called country codes. They're referencing country codes. We will do the same thing, but for us, it will be team locations. So I'm going to create a new model here. We'll call this example team details dot SQL. And how we'll write this here is we're going to reference the original model here first. And then in the next one, we'll say team locations as, and this time we'll do the same thing, but instead of the name of a model, we're going to use the name of this data file, team locations. Now let's join them together. Now let's deploy this model to see if it worked. dbt run, use the model flag dash m, example team details. All right, success. Let's take a look. We now see team details. It has all the columns. Let's take a quick look at the compiled code, see what happened here. Team details. So you can see it took our original model. For here, it looked at public team locations, so it understood where this is deployed and the name of it. Even though it's in a different schema, DBT knows where to look. And then it joins them together. So to recap, we added a CSV file to our data folder. And the reason we put it in the data folder is because that's where we're indicating this here. We could always change this, but this is the default. We referenced this file in our new model using the ref function and joined it to an existing model. So you can see there's, obviously this is a very simple example, but there's a lot of cool use cases. As they mentioned, you know, filtering test records, keeping country codes or maybe specific user IDs that you need to reference, but it's not really going to change often. So I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please feel free to like the video, leave a comment, and I will see you at the next one. Thank you.